Welcome to Pacific Update, our weekly news roundup for the region. Coming up, the Wallabies show their Samoan side and Prince Arthur speaks out about the Carver Club. But first, Fiji continues to grapple with soaring COVID numbers, with daily cases sometimes in excess of 300. There have been more than 20 deaths and a notable increase in positive patients with severe disease. The Australian and New Zealand medical team is now out of quarantine, and their first stop was to Suva's Colonial War Memorial Hospital. They met with senior hospital staff to get an idea about operations on the ground, which will help them advise the Fijian government over the coming weeks. Dr. James Fong is predicting there will be a higher daily number of cases, hospitalisations and deaths, particularly in the central and western division. There are now more than 4,000 active cases. In the Cook Islands, more than 9,000 people have received the Pfizer vaccine. In Mauke, the entire eligible population got their first dose, and the other outer islands are about to get theirs. The vaccine will be ferried out to some of the more remote islands without airport runways. Samoa's Supreme Court has ruled Parliament must sit within 7 days, but there are some indications that this might not happen. The court ruled that the swearing in of the FAST party outside Parliament in May, after the doors were locked, was unlawful, but it's instructed all relevant parties the Legislative Assembly must meet, and anyone who tries to stop this will face court charges. The FAST party currently has the numbers to form the next government, but the HRPP leader, Tuila Epasailele Malialengaoi, says Parliament can't reconvene until all legal challenges are dealt with. There's been a mass protest in West Papua, with protesters barricading government buildings and offices. The demonstration was over Indonesia's appointment of an unelected official as acting governor. The actual governor, Lucas Nembe, has been in Singapore receiving medical treatment and said he had not been informed or made aware of the appointment. French President Emmanuel Macron is leading talks this week about its nuclear testing in Tahiti. The two-day Paris meeting will look at the impact of 193 tests during the 90s and what can be done to help those affected. A new study has concluded that the whole French Polynesian population would have been affected by the tests, not just those around Moreroa Atoll. Macron has promised locals that France would take responsibility for health care for those suffering from radiation. Many of those affected still haven't received compensation. A Tahitian delegation is at the talks, but critics say it should be dealt with at a UN level to ensure real justice is done. There's been some controversy in Tonga after Prince Ata, the youngest son of King Tupou VI, yelled out about misappropriation of money at a Catholic Church function and in front of Cardinal Mafi. While a list of donors was being read out, Prince Ata shouted out that one of those donors, a Carver Club on his estate, was misappropriating money. Travellers to the Cook Islands found themselves in the midst of some very untropical-like weather. The Air New Zealand flight tried valiantly to land, but the crosswinds made it impossible. Visitors finally made it to Rarotonga a day later for a well-earned holiday. While the Cook Islands is enjoying open borders with New Zealand, not so other countries. Tonga has had to scour New Zealand looking for troops to take on the All Blacks, with many of its players and staff stuck overseas. 15 new caps are in line to debut for Ikalitahi at Mount Smart, many of whom have put down the tools for a week to take up the opportunity of a lifetime, like Samuela Molly.
I was on the tools. Then got a Tonga number, called me and picked it up, and Tautai's like, Sam, do you want to play for Ikale? And I'm like, what?
Many of the squad are still stuck in Europe and the team's management is in Tonga because of closed borders. The Wallabies have shown their true colours off the field. After a full week of training for the July Australia versus France series, the team showed their skills singing a Samoan song and prayer. Now to our social media vids of the week. Is it a bird? Is it a plane? No, it's an incredibly unwise dude on a motorbike. He'll need superhero powers to avoid a nasty accident. You know those days when life seems so hard and opening doors just feels like a step too far. And talking of hard, who hasn't had trouble folding fitted sheets?
And then you go like this.
Fortunately, there's an easy solution. Well, that's it for another week. Stay safe, and I'll be back next Friday with another Pacific update.